Y'all, it's been a month since last time I got my haircut. It is January 26th. My last haircut, I think, was... Let me look at my calendar. Actually, I can go back and look at it. My last haircut. Yes, actual haircut. Like, getting my hair cut was December 8th. Is that not... Wait, that's a lie. December 14th. That's like a month and a half of no haircut. And if y'all know me, no, that's like a hell no. I get my haircut religiously the same time, the same day, every week. But I'm about to switch it up to weekend haircuts now just because I want to start going to the gym 5 days a week. So I need the full Monday through Friday. I need that whole time open so I can get my body right. Like, it's y'all, okay, it's January 26th. March is right around the corner, and if you live in the South, you live in Atlanta, you know that it's March is when it really starts, you know, heating up, end of March, beginning of April. So I need to get this shit together so that when it's time to put on some short sleeve shirts and tank tops, I got my body, you know, popping out how I want it. Anyway. Oh, you know what, y'all? I didn't want to talk about. Real quick, let me just, I'm going to just have like a slight little therapy, you know, little boys talk with y'all. Boys chat. So, I don't know. I feel like I've been so focused on going to therapy and making sure that my mental health is where it needs to be, that I feel like I'm not letting myself go, but I know that I'm not taking care of my skin and my beard and my hair the way that I, you know, have in the past. And I'm just realizing, like, it's difficult to really be, like, physically, mentally, emotionally healthy, all three at once, because they take so much individual effort. Even just being emotionally stable, mentally healthy, that in itself, that is like a 24/7, 365 conscious decision. Like, it's like you're always having to assess yourself, assess your reactions, assess your feelings, assess your triggers, your trauma, assess your behavior. Like, it's like a full time, it's like a constant just state of assessing yourself, which, I mean, that probably is not the right way to do therapy and to be emotionally and mentally healthy. But I mean, like, I'm 30, like, I'm trying to, that was like one thing that I really, really wanted to start doing in my 30s, is make sure that Mike is, first of all, mentally and emotionally, no, not even emotionally. Let's do mentally healthy, right? And I've done a lot better. My anxiety is so minimal now. It used to be where I could not function. I'm gonna just be honest. I was at a point where I was not functioning if I did not have a drink to calm me down first, from doing basic tasks. Like, basic tasks. I needed a shot. I needed a sip of something to get me off the edge. You know what I mean? And so I've been doing dry January. And I'm going to be honest with y'all. I have not had any craving for alcohol, you know, vodka, tequila. My favorite drink that I love to drink every time I go out is a spicy margarita. have not had a craving for a spicy margarita, have not had a craving for a mojito, have not had a craving for, what else I like, a Moscow Mule. Have not had a craving at all. Not even for, like, a beer. I don't really drink beer, but I like, what's it called? The sweet ones that has the oranges in it. Blue Moon. I have not had a craving for Blue Moon. I haven't had a craving for any wine. And I love, because I'm like a big seafood person. So I love having white wine with my seafood. No cravings at all these past 26 days. And I'm also realizing that I just feel better. Like, I just feel not even just physically better, but just my mindset. I feel like I'm processing my emotions better. I feel like I am more creative. I feel like I'm more intentional. I feel like I'm more determined. I'm feel like I'm way more disciplined. So I think I want to just see how long I can go, you know, being off alcohol. And there was a part of me where I was like, well, since I'm not on alcohol, I got to find something else. And I'm like, well, actually, Mike, that way of thinking is not healthy. Like, I don't have to be consuming something just because I'm not consuming alcohol. Like, I'm going to be honest. I was like, maybe I should smoke. Maybe I should, you know, look at CBD oil. But I'm like, no. Like, I don't have to. And I talked this out with my therapist, and I was just like, I don't have to, you know, have any other coping mechanism, whatever, in my life to replace the absence of alcohol. That's the whole point, is to not have anything to use as a coping mechanism. The point is to be able to regulate myself well enough to the point that I don't need to drink, or I don't need to smoke, I don't need to take CBD, I don't need to do anything. That's what I need to get to. But back to my first point about just everything, what did I say? Physical, mental, emotional health being difficult to have control of all three at the same time. So emotionally, I feel like my emotional health right now is optimal. Like, my mental health right now is optimal. But my physical health, I'm not physically unhealthy, but I know that my skin is not what it used to be. I'm not doing my skin routine like I should be. My face skin and my body skin, you know, like I said, summer is about to be around the corner and I want to have my shirt off, but I got to get my, you know, I got dark spots. I have some chest. I don't know if it's really acne or maybe irritation. I really need to look at my diet. I know that I can't do dairy, but I just feel like my skin is really inflamed. It doesn't matter what products I use. I just feel like my skin is always inflamed. I'm always reddish. I'm always kind of irritated. My skin is just hyper sensitive. So I may need to go to a different dermatologist, because the one that I was going to, I'm gonna just be honest, he was white, and I just feel like white dermatologists, they don't understand, you know, black skin. That's just what it is, you know. There are different things that black skin needs that a white dermatologist is not gonna be able to give me. And that's no shade to any white dermatologist who might watch this video, no shade, but that's the truth. Like, I feel like I need a black dermatologist, or even a brown dermatologist. Excuse me. I had a dermatologist in middle school, and she was Southeast Asian. She might have been Middle Eastern. I don't want to, like, incorrectly label her, but I feel like even she understood my skin, because we were the same skin. She wasn't black, but we were the same skin color. You know what I mean? Whoa, did y'all hear those brakes? Anyway, we were the same skin color. So I feel like she understood what my skin needed. She understood how to combat and reverse, you know, dark marks and scarring and redness and irritation. Just because, like, there's different darker skin. Not that I'm not saying that I have dark skin, but y'all know what I mean. Skin that is not white, it reacts differently. There's different things to look for, different things to look at, you know? So I just feel like I need to get back and start researching and get back with a black dermatologist or brown dermatologist and just get my skin back together. And I know I can start that just by going to like Sephora and Ulta and getting up, picking up some projects, set aside like a skincare routine schedule. I think I'm gonna start a self-care Sunday series. So yes, I think that's perfect. Self-care Sundays, just like a whole wellness, mental, everything day. That's really what I need. But yeah, that was a long conversation. I think it was good though. Hopefully y'all are not skipping it, and hopefully y'all listen to the whole thing, because I actually did say some good stuff. But you know what, give me a thumbs up if you made it to the end of this rant. So I'm on the way home now. We're going to the Hawks game tonight, so I will see y'all at the game. I just recorded a whole video talking to y'all, but the microphone wasn't turned on. So I'm just say a recap of what I said. So, damn, I don't even know. I was just like going on and on. Make sure when y'all record, y'all double check. Make sure your mic is on. Make sure you're in focus on the viewfinder. Or else you're going to be stuck like Chuck. Let me double check it again. All right. Yeah, that's crazy. But anyway, that's so crazy. That's the type of weekend it is. Anyway, like I said, y'all seen Friday, I went to the basketball game. I got my hair cut. I was saying today is a content day because I didn't have a haircut for the whole month of January, right? And so I wasn't really on Instagram because I was like, that's not the vibe to be on Instagram with no haircut, looking crazy to me. I think I would look crazy with no haircut on Instagram trying to post pictures. I just like looking a certain way. So anyway, today's a content day. Taking y'all with me. Think I'm gonna try to do maybe 3 outfits. And yeah, honestly, I do not know what. I was just rambling the first time I was talking. That is so crazy. I gotta get better at that. Make sure the mic is turned on. Make sure everything is set before I hit record. All right, y'all. I'm gonna see y'all out there taking pictures. Oh, let me say, okay, self-care Sunday series. I talked about it on Friday. I'm going to be filming it on this camera, and I'm going to be filming Self-Care Sunday a week in advance. So this Sunday that y'all are seeing on YouTube now, you'll see it next Sunday on Instagram. And I'm doing that so that I don't have to shoot, film, and edit all on the same day. It just makes it better to plan the content that way and to really see what I'm doing and make sure the quality is like exactly what I like it to be. So yeah, we're going to be filming reels on this camera, Self-Care Sunday on this camera, all that, because I'm just trying to be like quality over quantity, right? So, all right. Yeah, no more rambling because I really lost track of what I said the first time. So I'm going to just see y'all out there while I'm taking pictures. What's up, y'all? It's like it's 11:13. Y'all saw some of the pictures, some of the process. It was so fucking cold. But I started editing, started picking out my favorites. I was gonna go ahead and just like knock it all out and like pick the pictures for the post and type a caption, tag the outfit, do my hashtags, all that, and just set it to post as a scheduled post on Instagram. But honestly, I'm tired. So I think I'm gonna just call it a night. Watch, I don't know. I might start a new horror story season. So last weekend I binged Asylum, and this weekend I binged Cult. Before I seen those two, the only seasons that I had seen all the way through was Coven, 1984, and Apocalypse. And Coven was my favorite. I feel like Coven's everybody's favorite. Coven was my favorite. But now I think my favorite is Cult, actually. Cult, that was a really good story. And I like that it was a lot more like real. Like, it was like, it wasn't so much like a ghost story or like somebody has powers, you know what I mean? It was like a psychological thriller type vibe, which is my vibe. I like that. I love those kind of movies. I like those kind of shows. So yeah, I think my new ranking, Cult is like up here, and then I'm gonna do Asylum next, then Coven, then Murder House. I saw Murder House the week before I binged Asylum. So Cult, Asylum, Coven, Murder House, Apocalypse, 1984. I tried to get in the Freak Show, but I don't know, y'all. I was not feeling the storyline. But I don't want to rank it unfairly because I only made it through the third episode. So I want to at least make it through half the season before I decide to like give up or not. But, oh, one thing I did want to say. Well, two things. So, I need to just do better at just, this is a short, kind of like low-key, no-content vlog, because I feel like I wasn't doing anything, and I feel like that's not entertaining to watch. But I don't know who I saw this from, but I was looking at a content creator's video somewhere. I don't know if it was TikTok, YouTube, Instagram. I really don't remember. I just remember that they were saying, like, stop focusing so much on trying to produce content or produce a story to tell your followers. People follow you because they want to see you. Like, it doesn't matter what you're doing, your followers just want to see you. And I was like, I never thought about it that way, but that's true even for me. Like when I follow people, it's because I think they're interesting. I like their sense of style. I think they're inspiring in some way. And me following them based off of that first kind of interest, it then leads me to just being interested in everything that they do from that point forward. You know what I mean? So I have to just think about it that way. People are subscribed to this channel, or they click follow on on Instagram, they click follow on TikTok because they want to see what Mike is doing, what Mike is up to. You know what I mean? Like that's what it is on social media. People follow each other because they want to see what you're doing. So I gotta get better at just picking the camera up, just talking, recording, even if I don't think it's entertaining or interesting, just show it. And I think that'll also build a habit of just pulling the camera out and recording, and it'll make me just make me feel more comfortable on camera also. So that was the one thing I want to say. The second thing, at the basketball game on Friday, y'all, I was tempted to get a shot because, I don't know, I felt a little bit of anxiety just because it was a huge crowd. And I was like, okay, if I just get one shot, then it won't break the dry January. But I ended up not getting it. And I'm glad I didn't, because that proved to myself that I don't need to have a shot to calm down or to like ground myself. Like I talked about a couple of days ago in the car, where there was a point where I needed a shot to do anything stressful. And it got to the point where I needed like a shot or a drink to do like basic shit. So that's a really big win. We gotta stop and acknowledge that the fact that I felt anxious, I felt uncomfortable, uneasy, and just out of pure habit, I wanted to go find a bar and take a shot. I mean, also it's a basketball game. There's more alcohol than there is water, you know? So if I wanted a shot, it would have been so easy to go get one and take one. But I recognize that that is a huge personal accomplishment. And I'm glad I didn't break my dry January. I'm on 28 days. It's January 28th. So I need to hit dry January, day 31. What's that? That's Wednesday. We're going to do it. But yeah. Sorry this was not more entertaining, y'all, but like I said, I'm going to just get better at picking the camera up. Just pick it up, press record, and boom. But yeah, I'm going to call it a night. I'm going to finish watching YouTube that I'm going to put on either Horror Story or SVU. But yeah, that's it. Thanks, y'all, for watching. I'll see y'all in the next one. You rock everything. You make me dream in my arms, top everything.